Traveling the world, whether it is by car or plane, or train or boat, can be unpredictable. In combining sailing and traveling the world, sometimes I feel like there isn't any control other than where pointing the bow of the boat feels best. And even then, sometimes we literally have no idea where we are going to end up. I think that's what freedom is. Giving up on trying to control things and going with the flow of life. It's more a mental state of mind, I think, and one thing about freeing yourself of control is, suddenly, anything becomes possible.
We have arrived.
Now, not to say that we don't plan things or enjoy structure when we can find it, and it's not often that we don't have at least some idea of what we are going to be doing in a country we decide to visit.
Going on a walk.
Even before sailing to the Bahamas for the first time, we knew some of what to expect. Crystal clear water, learning how to catch and cook fish, and learning how to sail on the ocean. In Panama, we knew we had one goal, and that was to get to know this new boat, Boundless. Sailing to Nicaragua marks our third country with her. And not only did we not know what to expect in this new country, maybe it's because we hadn't even considered stopping here, but our new friends Becka and Zach also had no clue what we were going to get into. Well, this week we are hiking two of Nicaragua's 40 volcanoes, sliding down the face of an active one on sketchy plywood boards, and then sleeping with the cows on the top of the second. But our first impressions were not the exciting thrills of volcano boarding and camping. It was the Marina Puesta Del Sol that has a sprawling estate-like feel. Beautiful buildings, we were told, filled with hotel rooms, but nobody was home. We had the place all to ourselves, aside from a few other cruising boats. And the beaches, wow. Some of the most breathtaking we've seen. Mango trees are everywhere, and the marina employees have a great method for reaching the perfectly ripe fruit.
Wow, he has a good hand. What a stroke of luck, huh?
Mm-hmm.
The best mangoes we've ever tasted. And Katie has a pouch full of them now.
I said, you go picking like this for apples.
Where we're from, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, so Becca, Zach, and I just dropped off our laundry at this little house. The little girl has all of her little puppies, and I'm guessing it's her mom who does the laundry here.
Boat dog.
Everybody wants a boat dog now. You can see. There's the sign.
We spent a few days resting and relaxing from the passage, eating delicious sourdough from Buns of Paradise, and awaiting our laundry before packing our bags and piling into a taxi to the city of León.
I think it was Spanish.
Muchas gracias, mi amigo.
Claro, chicos.
So we're staying in a place called the Bigfoot Hostel, and that's where we've scheduled a few different things that we're going to be doing this weekend. A couple of tours. And yeah, it's kind of exciting. Being in Nicaragua, this is the city of León, L-E-O-N.
It is the second largest city in Nicaragua and only a couple of hours from the marina. It was founded in 1524 by Spanish conquistador Francisco Hernandez de Cordoba at the base of the Momotombo volcano. But the city was forced to move due to an earthquake and volcanic eruption in 1610 to where it is located today. What a change of scenery. Colorfully colored colonial architecture lines street after street. With our hostel named Bigfoot teeming with young people from all over the world nestled between local restaurants and shops. We tried some local food, took a quick tour of one of the clothing stores, and then it was time.
Because when we finish our fabrics, the next end is not the same in these frames, in this frame, in those frames.
Wow. Looks like a piece of oven. And here, we put this shirt face up by...
Volcano boarding's birthplace is here at Cerro Negro, the youngest and most active volcano in Nicaragua. It's only 167 years old and it stands over 2,300 feet tall. Its most recent eruption was in 1999, and we were told that historically it erupts every 24-ish years. Which puts the next one about, any day now.
So we're sitting on a volcano that could erupt right now.
Honestly, yeah.
And we're about to slide down and on boards.
Oh, it's so steep too.
We saw a video of someone breaking every bone in their body. Sorry, Mom.
An hour of near vertical hiking and we were at the top of this massive mountain of black dried lava. And in a few moments, we will be launching ourselves down the side. These vents are spewing smoke and the ground was actually too hot to touch. Every volcano has a crater and this one was massive and menacing. I cannot believe we are on the top of a volcano in Nicaragua. It is just so funny sometimes where you end up.
Baby, gira el pal relajo, la que me pone las nubes. Champa, mued pa' enfiestarnos. Esta vida me merezco porque siempre ha sido la que había soñado. Y también para mis viejos no se olvidan a la línea y bien cuidados. Con su carro y casa nueva, gracias a Dios y a mis santos no les fallo. En un SRT blanco me verán por la ciudad, en el freeway manejando a toda velocidad. A la línea y bien cambiado y oloroso, a Versace con un Rolex en la mano y una dama pa' charlar. Y si tienen una duda, pues se las puedo aclarar.
You look like a coal miner.
Oh, I got so much in my eyes. I just couldn't see anything.
All right. All right, Katie, May. I know I got some in my eyes too.
So much in my eyes.
Yeah.
Thank
you.
Help me.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, I didn't think that was you at first.
Really?
Yeah. Here.
But now, go to now with the face. How do you feel with the yellow back turn? Like, I have one, I just don't have one.
I mean, at the beginning, I was just like, I need to go slow. Then, about halfway down, I was just like, dig your heels in, dig your heels in, dig your heels in. And then it was like, I'm not slowing down. And I just like, sent.
You rocketed, yeah.
Oh, was that video?
Yeah. Oh. It was a video.
As the sun set, we talked about how amazing it was that we experienced something like volcano boarding. But we had no clue that we also signed up for a bus that transforms into a nightclub. Loaded.
You are so pretty. Look at you.
We're gonna start a coffee table book called Cats at the Coast. Cats everywhere. There we go. Along the coast.
That's actually really good. I guess.
These are the most beautiful cats I've seen out of any country that we've been to,
mm-hmm.
For sure. You're so pretty, sweetie. Yeah. Hi. She's purring.
Later the next day, we stumbled upon a World Heritage site, the 18th century Cathedral of León, the biggest in Central America. Construction began in 1747 of this enormous rectangular structure, designed by Guatemalan architect Diego José de Pérez Esquivel. He used design trends from his home country as inspiration, and if not its sheer size, the all-white color certainly stands out among its surroundings. Inside, we found incredible works of art, congregation areas, and other significant pieces of history on display. We heard that you could walk on the roof of the cathedral, and so after a bit of searching and purchasing of tickets, we found ourselves climbing the narrow staircases to the top.
Hola.
It's forbidden to wear shoes or sandals, okay?
Shoes. This other one says don't take your shoes. What are they talking about?
Can you say a little about where we are?
We are at a cathedral in León. It is what kind of León is known for, is this architecture, but specifically this cathedral, which is also technically a basilica. I would have to go back to my Catholic roots to figure out the difference between a cathedral and a basilica, unless they're technically the same thing. But these white domes are what this basilica is known for. And so you can come out on the roof on the, with the white domes and walk around in your bare feet.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
There's like this, I don't know, crazy, like how magnificent places like this are, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Note working on the roof of a cathedral. Oh, hey, I think I know you guys. Walking with this kind of history beneath my bare feet feels profound, to say the least. The skill of the people who built this work of art in 1747 rivals, in my opinion, some skills of today. I've had some experience with masonry work, building walls out of cut stone, laying bricks, and pouring concrete. Yet, I can only try to imagine the monumental effort to build something of this magnitude out of brick and stones and mortar. The next morning, we piled into another vehicle with our sights set on El Hoyo, another of the active volcanoes in Nicaragua's section of the Ring of Fire, lining the edges of the Pacific Ocean. It was surprising the difficulty of the hike, especially with loaded packs.
Well, we just started the ascent, and we're going straight up the volcano. Oh my gosh.
There are 452 volcanoes along the Ring of Fire. And 90% of all earthquakes originate somewhere along it.
That's whatever a spider pig does.
The Ring of Fire was created by tectonic plate movement, piling up huge layers of Earth's crust, forming mountains, and with all of that movement, cracks and fissures allowed pressure to escape, spewing molten rock and forming new crust. El Hoyo is part of the Las Pilas volcano complex, and although active and still smoking in various places, hasn't erupted in a very long time. Unlike Cerro Negro, green vegetation has come back to life, and in many places, the hiking was along narrow paths through thick jungle. The ascent took about 4 hours and started out hot and humid. As we gained elevation, we noticed a cooling of the air temperature, and so our sweaty clothes began cooling our bodies. A welcome change. Soon, we were hiking through the clouds.
made it. Camping up here. Yeah.
The campsite hadn't been used for a while and was invaded by a herd of cows who used the entire area as a giant litter box. After cleaning up and setting up the tents, we settled into the surreal experience of camping at around 3,000 feet above sea level.
So what are your thoughts on the hike? That was tough. That was a tough hike.
Hey everybody, I hope you're enjoying the episode. I just wanted to pop in here and say, if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our channel and leave a comment and don't forget to like the video. All of that interaction really helps our channel get spread across the YouTube universe, and it's totally free. If you're already subscribed and wondering how else you can support us, you can head over to patreon.com/sailingseawind to buy us a coffee or choose the tier of your liking. Our patrons get some pretty cool perks, including a live predict wind tracking link and ad-free early viewing of each week's episode. All right, that is all. Back to the video.
Where's the road that you can hear?
What?
Where's the road? You can hear like trucks or cars.
Are you a little moo cow?
I'm one of the cows.
The last explosion was October 29th to the 31st in 1954. Erupting from the central crater in El Hoyo.
You're wild, huh?
Mm-hmm.
How about how you can see all of the layers of the earth? It's pretty wild.
I'm not sure if it was exhaustion from yesterday, but the descent seemed in some ways harder than the ascent. Most of the hike is over loose gravel and, well, gravity took over a few times.
Right? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah! It was a slip and then another slip.
We eventually made it back into the hot and humid jungle at the base of the volcano, hiked around a beautiful freshwater lake, and a few hours later, we were back in civilization. What an unexpected and beautiful experience in Nicaragua. It always seems to be the unplanned places that we visit that make for the greatest adventures. With buns of paradise in hand and a pool to recover in, we soaked up the last days in the marina. Up next, we say goodbye to this amazing country with the hopes we will be back someday, and set sail for the longest passage we've ever done.